Developers, how many of you are Android developers? Yes, so hardcore Android developers, here to appreciate hardcore Android developers. So all over to the first Android app demo by Anint. So Anint, go ahead. Round of applause, guys. Yay.
Thanks, guys. Good afternoon. Hi, I'm Anant, and I'm going to talk about an app that we developed in DroidCon Hack Day that happened like few weeks before. So I, Kreis, and Zubair, like, we teamed up to build this app. So before getting into what this app does, I want to do a like quick few slides on like why we built this app. So as you know, like, there are like tons of apps available in App Store, or not just App Store, so many other alternate app stores out there. And any idea like how many approximate apps are out there in Play Store as of now? Any some numbers? No, it's 700,000 apps out there. And I mean, just from the sheer number, you find that like discovering good apps is a huge problem. So there are actually companies like and apps that actually came in to solve this app discovery problem. One popular thing was Chomp, but it got acquired by Apple, so this app is no more. But I also discovered there are other apps like Playboard, App Disco. But I mean, I actually discovered this only yesterday when I was researching for the slides. And another thing is AppStorm, where you get reviews on good apps, curated by authors of AppStorm. And many of my friends recently have moved to Android. So the moment when they get a new Android phone, many of my friends call me and ask, can you recommend me good Android apps? So I mean, they know that like I develop apps and then I talk about Android a lot. So they want good recommendation from me. So what I usually used to do is like tell them few app names or SMS or email, and they used to miss them by not searching the right apps, and all those things happen. So that's when I built this app like about a year back called Apps Cloner. So it actually built this to solve my own problem. Like as they say, like building a good app, you try to scratch your own itch. So I had this problem of sharing apps that I wanted to tell to my friends. So I built this app where it's just a simple app that lists all my installed apps. I just pick them one by one and then I say share. It actually immediately opens my Gmail and then it fills all the list of apps, name and their link to the App Store directly. So my friends can directly open it, click one by one and then done. So I'll just show a short demo of what that app did. Yeah, so this is the app, Cloner app. So the moment I open it, loads all the apps that I have in my phone right now. So I just say like, I want to recommend FindRedPX, Astro File Manager, and maybe Carbon to my friends, and then just share. Yeah, it's a spelling mistake, yeah. I mean, like, it automatically has listed all these apps, and then the link to the App Store is directly over there. So, I mean, it solved my problem, and I was happy with it. And I was also using it too when people ask in WhatsApp, I was using this and all good, and, I mean, all happened. But for me, to discover good apps, the best thing that I usually do is like over my social network feed, like I keep getting like, I would recommend this app and the other app stuff. So I actually discover lots of my favorite apps like Timely, maybe FindRedPX, Zite, through the social feeds. So I actually depend on my social circle to discover good apps. And if we look the problem deeply in it, like that lots of people spend some time in getting good apps, curating the apps in their phones, but it just stays in their phone. How do we actually make a way in which like people, the effort people put in discovering good apps is reached and then made reusable? So if you think, if you know, I mean, obviously you must have heard of Delicious. So it gives an awesome way to share bookmarks. You can actually create a list of bookmarks of some particular category, and then you can share with friends. So I thought, like, why not build something for apps? So that's when we I kind of ideated upon this idea called AppFolio, where you build a Delicious for just Android apps. So how does that work? So I'll just show the demo of the app directly. So it's similar to the apps cloner app. So I have all the apps, So all the apps in my phone listed here in a neat grid view. So I just browse through them. Select a few good apps I already have. Like maybe I like the HasGeek funnel app, so add it here. And then maybe I also like SixiGo. And then I say like share. Over here, what happens is like not the complete list of apps are shared, but just a link. It's like my I connect the my I mean create an account with AppFolio with my Twitter account. So appfolio.me/my name gives a list of apps that I actually recommend to people. So how does it look in browser? So I had now shared a couple of apps. Let's see how my browser shows it. Hopefully internet works. Yeah, so basically like my, it's basically a simple web page that just has the links that I've shared over here. And hover on it and click, it directly takes to the Play Store. And I have made, I mean, at least we have made this app completely like responsive, where whatever kind of tablet you see, it adapts automatically. You click on it, it opens the App Store directly, and then it's directly consumable. So maybe in future, we would like to add stuff like popular lists that are curated in one place, or maybe even custom lists like entertainment apps, my favorite entertainment apps, my favorite sports apps. Those all can be also brought in. So the app actually, like we kind of polished it for over past weeks, and today we are officially launching at DroidCon. So do download it, appfolio.me in Play Store. If you have good feedback, do write to us at we are on Twitter at Anant and Crazy King. Thank you.
Hello. I'm Sanju. I'm from Vumi. And this is Ankit Goyal. So let's start with what is Vumi. So we are a platform for ultimate live TV interaction and engagement. So let me start with the problem of current TV watching. In the traditional way, there is no engagement. It's quite boring. There are no interactive shows, extra or exclusive content to engage the user. So this is the problem we are trying to solve here. So how do we do this? So we have a secret sauce for this. We have a patent pending sound recognition technology which detects the program which the user is watching and pushes very relevant and exclusive content to them. So let's take a few sample scenarios. So how about watching a Nike advertisement and getting an instant offer from the TV directly to your phone at that instant itself? Just check out the video I am playing now. I'll play once more. So this is the Tommy Hilfiger advertisement, and Vumi detects that the user is watching Tommy Hilfiger and pushes relevant offers to him. And how about Bollywood trailers? Nowadays, Bollywood trailers are not interactive at all. So how many of you guys know about Shazam? Yeah. For the guys who don't know, it's a service by which you can tag music. So similarly, Vumi is Shazam for live TV advertisements and movies, Bollywood promos and songs. So let me play one more video. So this is the trailer of Krish 3. So Vumi detects that the user is watching Krish 3 trailer, and we aggregate literally all the content for Krish 3, like Facebook page, Twitter, its Wikipedia page, IMDb. So in the exclusive section, there are videos, pictures, there may be voting, polling, contests, trivia, all those things. So these are some of the screenshots of it. This is the exclusive page where we get direct content from the Bollywood movie studios and production houses, like behind the scene videos. So next time when you watch a Bollywood promo, just tag it with Vumi and get exclusive behind the scene videos, exclusive images, and you can take part in the contest, poll, etc. So these are some of the other features, live TV chat around the TV shows, and this is a screenshot of contest. And we have had a pilot run with 3 TV channels in India. One is ETC Bollywood, then Big CBS and Star, and we have 10,000 plus users as of now. So just download Vumi and tag the Bollywood promos and advertisements with Vumi. So that's it. I can show you one more video. This is the promo we got when we had a pilot run with Star Channel. So, any questions?
Hi, it's a nice app. I just want to know, are you detecting the audible audio or high frequency audio?
Sorry, detecting the audible?
What are you detecting? Is it an audio which is audible to the, the humans?
The thing is that, actually, we index each and every second of the audio, whether it's live TV, whether it's an advertisement, whether it's movie promo, and it will be in our server. So what happens when Vumi opens, it listens to the surroundings, record the sound, record each second of the sound, and sends to the server, matches it, and that's how it's done.
Correct. So my second question is, where are you hosting that entire library of all the audios which you're detecting? You know, where are you meta tagging that with that... whatever is being aired 24/7 across all channels, which is like a huge database, right? And then you'll be running, sending the request back, it will scan the entire library out on your server.
Actually, there are two scenarios for this. One thing is the pre-recorded one. That means the content we'll get in advance, just like Bollywood promos or advertisements, these contents we already have. In that case, we follow one technology, and in the other case, it's like for the live TV, it's another technology. For example, if you're watching a live IPL match, anyway, we are not able to get the content before. So in that case, what we do is that we index each content and send to the server. What happens is that there is a delay all across India while broadcasting. Sometimes the thing which gets broadcasted in Bombay will be delayed 3 seconds. It will be broadcasted in Delhi. So in that case, we delay it and store it in the server. So what happens when the mobile app opens, it detects the sound, makes a delay of 5 seconds and sent to the server. So it will be already in the server and just matches it. And there will be a buffer, like we won't store the entire thing. We remove the old ones and we will keep the database to be minimal.
So have you already tried this on a long form content? Like these are the clips, right? And some of the test videos that you have. But
yeah,
have you tested on a live full length 3 hours movie or a 2 hour movie?
Yeah.
Okay, thank
actually,
you.
We have enabled this technology on 8 TV channels. You guys can, if you open the app, you can see which are those 8 channels, like MTV, ETC, Bollywood, Zoom. So you guys can test it from December 1 onwards, live TV.
Thank you. Thank you.
So for starters, I find this interesting. Okay, I'm a brand marketer. I've been marketing brands for quite some time, and I think these are areas where I think brands can really, really benefit from.
Yeah.
I'd like to understand, as a business, how are you going to scale? Because, see, 10,000 app downloads for me is too small a number as a brand marketer to directly invest in something like this. So how do you scale? Do you scale through the media channel?
Yeah. I'll show one more sample video since you asked this question.
Right.
So we were the official mobile partner for American Idol last season. So I will show the promo they had given for us. I was trying to play the promo given by American Idol team for us. So when there is in the, for example, if you are watching American Idol, there will be an Aston band at the bottom of that video saying, download Vumi to take part in the contest and get exclusive content. So this will be shown periodically, like 15, at regular intervals of 15 minutes. So people can, all the viewers and fans of American Idol will surely see this. And that's how we get promoted. And earlier I showed a Star Channel video. Yeah, let's show this. Can you see this? Download Vumi app for. So this is the promotion we got from American Idol. So similarly, the earlier video I showed you is a promotion given by Star Shopping Channel. Yeah, they will have exclusive promos for us, 30-second promos, or just like this, Aston bands.
Sure, but I'm thinking if I was running this business like you are,
okay,
I wouldn't rely on the media channel alone. Why can't I reverse monetize it, wherein, you know, I build an app which can possibly pass on some of this revenues to even people who are streaming these ads, like, you know, people who are actually using this interactive content. Right, and possibly build an app with let's say a proposition where, you know, your users who are downloading it on the app store see a value, and you increase your downloads that way, and not necessarily depend on the media.
For the users is the exclusive content and behind the scene videos. It's just exclusive for the Vumi users. If it's the case of a Bollywood promo, or if it's case of an advertisement. If Puma want to push 1 million offers to all its viewers, it can be just done in 1 second. So that's the value addition we are offering to the user. So,
excuse me, ma'am. I think you can take it offline. Sanju is available for you. You can. Thanks, guys. Thank you.
Hi, good afternoon to Ornamental Present here. Myself Srinivasan from Chennai. My app is Smart Glucose Meter. What this app mainly deals, actually lot of apps are there present in the field, but we have some different distribution we have done in this app also. What's the thing is, my major objective is to measure the blood glucose level, then to maintain some accuracy, which should be related to analog, so that the physicians too can understand what the value is similar or not. In such case, I need to convey a scenario that in my native, a person went for a blood sugar test. He got a reading at analog, that is in lab, he got a reading which is entirely different to the reading what he got in the digital meter. The same issue should not be done like this. I have done this app for Android so that he can make the log in his mobile too. Here my second objective is porting the peripheral device. Actually, a peripheral device will be there, which will have the blood strips, that is to measure the glucose in it, some chemical which will be present in the glucose. When a drop of a blood is placed in the blood strip, it will be converted into ferricyanate so that some electrons will be flowing in that strip, so that it will be passed into the device and we will get the PWM signal. Finally, we will get the PWM signal from the device. I need to induce that PWM based signal into the Android mobile via the 3.5 mm audio jack. Here what my project deals with is converting the PWM to PCM. The conversion should take place. For each and every analog to digital conversion or to digital to analog conversion, there will be some loss. Especially, I am not bothering about the propagation delay, but I am bothering about the quantizing noise, which makes a more error there. For example, analog signal is converted into digital signal. In the same way, it should be sampled and then it should be quantized, and finally we will get the codes, that is a digital codes. In such case, I am just making that quantization, the quantization level, and the quantization level and the quantization error. I am just reducing the quantization error. How is it that the logic deals with this? The quantization error will be maximum at the mid value of the signal. For example, if a signal has 0.5 or 0.7, it may be goes to 1 or 0. In the same case, I am just reducing the quantization error, and so that I will get the accurate result. That's why the project is different from the other blood glucose monitor. First of all, how we implemented is, I have taken a sine wave and put it in a MATLAB. Then I have gone for a round off function, then multiply the values into 1000 so that I get 10 lakhs and some values of samples. And that the values of samples have been given into the quantization methods, and the quantization finally brings out the result, which is not similar to the actual quantization, so that the same logic I used it in the Java code also, so that we find the result, it is perfect to the normal one. Then the signal difference is also somewhat maximum, that is we have reduced the quantization error so that we get the signal level, that is the original signal, that is what the ferricyanate signal will be there. We got the ferricyanate signal so that we are easy to plot the points accurately, so that I am not telling that we are accurate to the analog device what it is capturing, but we have plotted more than 10 lakhs of samples in the graph, and we have put it in a average value, and finally this algorithm works out so that we have submitted for the IEEE 2. And The same, they have also approved that this will be the maximum quantization reducing algorithm, so that it may be useful for that. So that in real scenario, we have implemented this and we have seen the modification and the same modification have been implemented, and we have given for the physician to test the same, and he also approved that it is okay, it's fine with the errors. And I need to show my screens. This is my first screen. While the peripheral device is connected via the audio jack, you will be getting this calculating your blood sugar level. So that the calculation will be gone there. Then this is our second screen. That is, you will get the current result and the diet, what you can take in afternoon. If you are taking by 7 a.m., if the test is going ahead by 7 a.m., then the lunch will be, this is as a prescribed one which is saved in the database. And in the same tapos, we have the show logs, and the show logs will have the history of the previous days what the tests have been taken there. And similarly, they can have the EOD test, that is the end of the day test, so that they can also see for 2 to 3 hours or 3 to 4 hours, yeah, test can be done here. And this is as shown in before slide. This is a current log where you can fetch the calendar information and you can click OK, so that the final result of that day and what diet you have taken and what are the exercises you have done, those things can be seen here. And finally, we are not only focusing upon the blood glucose monitor alone. Actually, a blood glucose monitor is secondary one. The major objective of this paper is the during conversion, the reduction of the quantization error, and the during some other conversion from digital to analog, whatever it may be, this algorithm will be the basic one to implement the other applications. That's it. Thanks. Any queries?
All right, guys, quick couple of announcements. Sony is giving out free Xperia Z Ultras right now. Okay, I've got everybody's attention. Those who aren't making it for tomorrow's sessions, very hot, very awesome sessions that are happening here, we're really sorry, we're going to miss you guys, but you guys have your badges, right? Drop it off at the registration desk. Those who are making it in tomorrow, bring your badges or no lunch. Okay, and lastly, you guys, when you came into the street that leads down to this convention center, you guys must have seen a restaurant, Counterculture. Really great restaurant, very good reviews online. We've got a special deal with them for all you guys. We love you. 50% off for dinner for everybody. Okay, just flash your registration badges again. Okay, and Sony is giving out a free Xperia Ultra Z. You got to just drop off your business cards. If you don't have one, make it. It'll be worth it. All right, cheers, guys.